very important to start a people's assembly here now. So I would like to invite everyone to come in this circle and stand in the circle. This is how we envisage the future.
We have two questions. That's how do you want to tackle the climate problems now in the world, which are worldwide, but we are local, so how do you want to tackle it? And what is your message to Bolivia?
There's lots of alternative systems already developed. There's lots of alternative technologies already developed. They're just suppressed. So my message to Bolivia is like, let's get all the data out, which was the whole debate in Copenhagen anyway, who's screwing over the data. So let's put all the data on the table so we can really figure out a bright, beautiful future that we're not stuck in the same repetitive system bullshit we've been in before.
There is one solution for all the problems what are on this planet, and that's love. With the love, I think we can unite each other. We have to unite in this struggle for a better world for us, for a better world for future generations, for a better world for farmers, for indigenous people, for everybody. Climate change is not just an environmental issue. We have to recognize that and fight for a better future altogether. It is also migrants issue, it is also workers issue, it is also feminist issue, it is also farmers issue, it is also nuclear energy issue, it is also animal rights issue. There is no anyone who would not face the consequences of the climate change, and we have to realize that, and politicians also have to realize that, because they will also get the consequences.
It's holistic, it's the whole round of life cycle, and we already know that. Ultimately, you only protect what you love. So it's really about having the courage to love life. Capitalism is very comfortable for most of us here, and people feel threatened by giving up the comforts that we have from capitalism. And I think that just helping people to understand that system change doesn't have to be a really scary, threatening thing to yourself and to your family and to those that you love. But if we actually don't change the system, then it will be a threat to the people that we love. And that maintaining your private property, for example, in the long run will lead you to being more stable, because we're actually undermining the planet.
But we will not turn the tide, we will not make the people changing their behavior by threatening them or by blaming them, but by educating them. Educating in a non-formal way like we do it here, by speaking face to face to the people. But it's more important also to integrate this kind of knowledge that what already exists, the solutions, but also explaining the people the mechanisms of economics, how environment works, how environmental degradation works, and how it is connected, how politics works. We have to integrate that also in a formal way, in the formal way of education, in the schools, so that we start also with the children. So that this becomes really a daily bread for the people, a mind food, that they are not need to think about it anymore, but they are just doing it, and they implement it in their daily life.
The education that the children get in this system, almost all over the world,
it's not education, it's a domestication. We have to employ new pedagogical system in which will be a conscious education, and only through that
I think we can achieve what the Whitson thinking of love and a transformation of humanity.
I think and there must be pressure on the big investments, I think also.
What I would very much like is to ask you to promote those activities that are taking place every day, every weekend, every month. Just let's make sure that we are sharing through internet, through email, making a telephone call. Just make sure that whenever there is something happening, that we are there and that we're bringing new people to there. My message to Bolivia is that I'm very proud that people who are taught not to be able to stand up for themselves, to people who have been told to be too poor to stand up for their own ideas and their own ways of thinking, that they are doing an alternative to what is what happened in Copenhagen. And I am very much sure that the ideas that are going to be raised up there, they're pretty much interesting alternative ideas that should be taken in account for the coming discussions and debates.
Shortly, abolish capitalism, the main evil in this planet.
And anybody can understand that if you buy a little radio or a cup for $2, that it's exploitation and destruction behind it.
Become vegetarian or even better, vegan. If you cannot, it's good if you at least will eat less meat, because meat production nowadays is bigger contribution to greenhouse emissions than all transport.
We have to stop the import of soya to be used to feed animals, because first, it's pure luxury, we don't need it. Second, it destroys rainforests, which is a biodiversity, which is incredibly important. And three, it destroys the living environment for many indigenous people. So I give this for consideration. I would like if we could, you know, write it down, say this People Assembly decided this.
Could we add to that the agrofuels? Holland had a big agreement with Brazil to import on a massive scale ethanol from sugarcane. It's the same problem with soybeans is going on with agrofuels.
Maybe we can ask who is against?
Nobody.
Who is for?
Okay,
that's I think a greater consensus we could have reached. Thank you.
There were three very concrete proposals. One was stop import of soya, that just has been accepted, for instance. Stop import agrofuels. And the other one, which is very important, which has been also formulated in Bolivia itself, is about economical autonomy, about local production, about producing for yourself, about food sovereignty. And I think that when it comes to this point, I think we all can agree that it's very important for us to be able to produce our own food, so that when something wrong goes on, that we are always able to count on ourselves, because we are producing what we need. At this moment, if we're going to have a problem in Holland, much of our production is already been passed over to other countries that supplies us through imports. So if for whatever reasons we have a problem with those countries, suddenly we don't have the supplies of food. So it's good and very important to be able to do that work on ourselves.
Promoting self-sufficiency for every region in the world.
Yeah.
So I think personally, like, anybody agree on system change? Yeah. Anybody disagree with system change? Okay, we'll put that on the list, you know. I would like, you know, it's kind of ambitious, but, you know, we gotta aim high when we're very low.
Let's continue this discussion. Let's talk more about the solutions, about alternatives. I would like to invite you all to participate, to get involved with our organization, with many other organizations who are busy with changing system and making this world a better place.